This is on the way to the Holy Eucharist. And being in the present path. When they went out, that was a little long. Those times when they visited me, I spoke on that to me. This is together, it reminded me that I was a community with whom I had a close relationship. In Philadelphia, it seems to be called Orthodox. I said, no. And I promise you, this time I will go. I need to get one to visit you. I was in Stratford, England, at a conference, which lasted for a week, which was organized by the Protestant Church of the world, who was considering the matter of the achievement was slowly going away from the church. So, there were programs and plans to keep the children in the church through various bodies. I was in Sonoma some 4 hours journey from Australia early, late last year, and actually the same product. Now they are spending millions of dollars to see whether children continue the tradition of their religious practices and spirituality in their lives too. One of the problems they are facing is the Catholic tradition and as well as in the Protestant tradition, children are not given Holy Communion soon after they are baptized. In our church, we administer communion soon after the service. So their children fail. Why are we not full participants of the experience of God in our churches? You go to church with us, you sing the hymns, and we also join you. You kneel down to pray, we also kneel down to pray. You put money in the offertory, we also put money in the offertory. But when you go to receive communion, something to eat, you don't take us. So we are not coming to church. That's the reason problem they are facing. So they are trying to learn from the Orthodox Church why and how the Orthodox Church is administering Holy Communion to the infants. And they are planning to have several conferences of this nature in various parts of the world during the coming 2 years. After having seen that, I started questioning myself, what am I doing to keep our children in the church? I keep thinking, because most of the time we don't do much, rather we try to keep our children away and tell them, Mundana Parunana Kavadagata. I think we need to do something after having seen their example. Probably we will do more concrete, of course we have many things that probably we will do more than what we have right now. In the Pudhinya Raja, Nathaya Kalyananda Bhagavad Gita Samaya, St. Thomas was a seeker of truth. Many a time in the society in which we live, we are being carried away and influenced by external forces. People talk about everything and anything according to their understanding or lack of understanding. Vinnaga Yerusalem was good.
അടുത്തവയുള്ള ഒരു സമൂഹം കിട്ടിയിട്ടുള്ളത് അപ്പോൾ ഉള്ളവരെ
സത്യം അറിയണമെന്ന് നിർബന്ധമില്ലേ? അവർക്ക് അറിയുന്ന അവസ്ഥയും ഇല്ലാത്ത സത്യം അറിഞ്ഞാൽ ശരിയാണ് അംഗീകരിക്കപ്പെടണം എന്ന് നിർബന്ധം. അങ്ങനെ ഒരു സമൂഹത്തിൽ തോമസ് ചേർന്നയുടെ സന്ദേശം വളരെ നിർണായകമാണ്. Before what happened with Jesus, there has never been a resurrection by himself or herself. Of course, Jesus during his lifetime brought into life a couple of people. But once he himself has died, then who will raise him from the dead? And therefore, it was not at all a possibility under the circumstances. People will tell all sorts of things. And Thomas did not go, want to go about it. He wanted to see and experience the truth that is resurrected. He knew that that would have binding on his later life. Something he didn't have experience cannot be preached for other people. That's the our problem. കുറച്ച് നിലവിളിച്ചു മാത്രമേ എന്താ സംഭവിച്ചു? അച്ഛനെടുത്ത് നോക്കി തിരിച്ചു കുടിച്ചു, നാളെ തിരിച്ചു തിരിച്ചു വെള്ളത്തിൽ നോക്കി ഏതാണ്ട് എന്നൊക്കെ നാട്ടുകാരെ പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. Baptism in our lives. But for Orthodox teaching, baptism is not something that happened in the past. That is something that happens the very moment in our life. And for that matter, there is no sacrament in Orthodox tradition which is done for one time. Rather, it is being lived through in our life in a very moment. And then baptism also gave to be an experience continued to life. And that is why Jesus told Nicodemus, unless you are born of water and spirit, you cannot enter into the kingdom. That becomes an everyday experience. We lie in Christ and we resurrect in Christ. When there is a challenge in our life, we look at it as a possibility of death. We could surrender ourselves to that challenge. And that's what many people do. Chillara tettu kaanikkanam enna challenge ulla vellivilla sandarbhathil nam palarkkum adu kaanichu. Adhanaanu naamukku theeranga varaiyathu. The reason they are looking into newspaper reports about the names of people who do all sorts of anti-social activities. Recently, a circle inspector in Malay got injured, not in a car accident or in any other kind of accident, because a bunch of students came together to celebrate the coming of New Year 2010. The celebration got out of hand. They started putting stones at the police. The police started charging them, and the circle inspector got out. And I looked at the names of people involved. Nine people were arrested. All of them were Christians. And that is why Dr. Ahar, the former president of India, said Christians are ordinary people. They get covered by Christians. ഒരു കാലത്ത് ആളുകളാണ്. പിന്നെ ചിട്ടി ഇപ്പോ വിസ കൊലപാതകം കക്ഷി വഴക്കിൽ ആളുകളെ ചുറ്റൂരെ go through that daily experience of Christ. We don't die in Christ, we are not therefore. Today, the day of St. Paul's school was a similar thing. That was as to be led, because we are called to be the children of St. Paul's. Thomas, we are the father, and the Zahir, and the Adam, and the day, and the Rosh Hashanah. What does it mean to be the children of St. Paul's? Follow the right path that he has shown us. The right path he has shown us is to be seekers of the kingdom. See whether in that subject. Some of the people are not in the world. They are not in the world. Some of the people are not in the world. They are not in the world. And I am using the word. Arbitrary. Saturday, some of the people are not in the world. We don't love people anymore. We love them on the basis of material, the resources they have. We don't love things. We multiply hate. We don't love brother. Rather, we always accept people only in our own economic or social field. And Christianity slowly becomes a religion of the dead. But Christianity is a religion of resurrection. Resurrection means not just from the physical, we overcome all kinds of temptations and challenges that will take away the better minds in our life. But prosperity and success are misinterpreted and are asked people to grow according to the material lifestyle and do whatever misuse they can do to achieve prosperity and success. Ashokai Ninichi Vidana Montichurunoi, Vinti Kashaka, Nibiola, Manishaka, the Samoa. Avadeya, Christianity Vindu, the Sarakada. Namada, the Sarakada. The Sarakshani and Yoshikina. അതിനെ പ്രസംഗിക്കുന്ന ഒരാളാണ് എക്കാലം നമ്മൾ എക്കാലം ഈ സത്യത്തെ അന്വേഷിക്കുകയും ജീവിതത്തിലെ ആദ്യത്തെ കണ്ടെത്തുകയും അതിനെ വക്താക്കളാക്കിയിരിക്കുകയും foundation of our lives and how to be process to that foundation, which is love in Christianity. Hatred prevailed before, and that is what made the Jews kill Jesus. But in Jesus, hatred died and now resurrected. That is the message of the resurrection. We need to now, in all honesty, all circumstances, and all areas of our life, and try to practice it in our daily life. Once a day, let's go on. Joy and happiness. I will be lucky to be with you this morning. I thank you and all of you.